and bless us with a couple of selections today. And it's Mr. Derek Smith. Okay.
How y'all doing this morning? Do me a favor and just give God a praise all over the building. Can we do that? Yeah. Give it up for the praise team this morning. They are singing out the depths of their heart. Come on, show them some love this morning. And we can't forget about this bad three-piece foot in the corner. Come on, give them some. And y'all do me a favor. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is my strength. Let me see y'all teeth this morning. Just begin to smile. I don't care if you got 32, 22, ain't got but two in your pocket. Go on and smile. It's all right. Y'all a little quiet this morning over here in the theater, but I came to make some noise for Jesus. Is that all right? I don't hear but five over here, so I don't think the microphone is on. I said, can we make some noise for Jesus this morning? Can I just hear you shout out hallelujah? Can I hear you say hallelujah again? Come on, put your hands together. You can bring that on up for me, bring that track on for me. It's all right. Come on.
Clap like this tonight. Clap like this tonight.
Come on and clap those hands all over the building.
Oh yeah.
I can steal you some on that track. Come on.
Transform. on by the renewing of your mind. Yeah. Say, create in me a clean heart. And renew the right spirit within me.
Check up from the neck up of God. meth this good, but it's nothing because of the grace and mercy of Jesus. Oh, y'all don't understand what I said. I said the grace and mercy of Jesus. Somebody said, well, what is grace? It is undeserved favor, unmerited favor. I didn't get what I deserved. See, I wish I had somebody that was really here. Oh, I wish I had somebody that know that you used to be out in the world, doing everything that you were big enough and bad enough to do. But I want y'all to know, as I look back over my life, I had some running partners that was running with me. And my running partners, they ain't able to stand nowhere and tell somebody that God kept them. Can I get a witness in here? I want y'all to know it's not by accident that I'm standing here in this theater this morning. But it's by divine assignment to let somebody know. I don't care how many times you go to Bible study, midweek service, conventions, revivals, and morning worship. If Jesus does not live in your heart, in hell you will lift your ass. Do y'all hear me in hell? We become so proficient and trying to make it look like we got it together. Why did we was talking about swag last night? And somehow we convinced ourselves, as long as we can make folks think that we're so deep, as long as we can make folks think that we're so connected, that's all right. But let me tell you what I found out. Folks can't heal your body when you're sick. Y'all don't hear me in here. Folks can't deliver your children off of drugs. Y'all ain't listening in here. Folks can't bring your marriage back together when your husband's acting up and your wife won't cook. Y'all don't hear me. Folks can't give you a job when unemployment hits your house.
Take out your iPhone. You need a favor. Text my hater and tell him. hands. Don't give him a halfway praise. He didn't give you a halfway blessing. He didn't wait to part you up and left the other half in the bed. And the God that I serve is a linguistical God. He's a God of language. So he loves communication. So many times we get caught up in church hype. But 2012, I've deemed as the year of authenticity. It's time to face it so you can fix it. Confront it so you can conquer. And if you are in this church, I'm going to be able to not only hear the word of God, but apply the word of God. Singing and praising is real. It has its place. But when you're on your job on Tuesday, and your co-worker, the one that's sitting beside you that you know you can't stand, when you want to slap her till her earrings go east and her weave go west, you're going to need Jesus. Unfortunately, some people are not going to come through the church door. Don't you realize that you may be the only Bible that someone may read? So as we celebrated yesterday, but even in the midst of whatever you've done, when you did it, where you did it, or who you did it with, even if it was last night, the God that we serve, the God that Pastor Lockett talks about, is an all-forgiving God. What I want to know is, do I have two or three of y'all in the sanctuary this morning that know that God has given you ultimate forgiveness in here? But somebody sitting beside you don't know that. But if you know that you've got that kind of relationship with God, do me a favor. I need some witnesses in here. So